Hey everyone, my name is Terry G. This is my alcohol-free life channel where we learn to live sober one day at a time. If you can take a second, can you please hit that subscribe button and don't forget to smash that like button. I really appreciate it. What a beautiful day today. I'm up at my off-the-grid cottage. It's Saturday morning. It's kind of cool. It's nice. It's nice in cottage country. Believe me, it's beautiful. It's about 55 degrees this morning, believe it or not. For July, that's pretty cool. But I'd just like to welcome everybody this morning. And what I'm going to talk about today a little bit about is making decisions in that first year of sobriety and how difficult it is in that first year and why we shouldn't make any major decisions. I call those decisions stress decisions because for myself, a lot of the big decisions that I made in my first year that caused me difficulties, I made under stress situations. Like for example, I was running out of money. I didn't have the buying power that I used to have when I drank, believe it or not. I was pretty broke. So where my place of living was, wasn't too great. So I met this woman and I decided because I was running out of money, it'd be easier to live with her. And let me tell you something, I paid dramatically. I paid dearly for that decision. So making those kind of decisions like changing your job, maybe going back to school, getting involved in a relationship, doing a big purchase, just big decisions that you think you need in that time, I would strongly recommend not doing it. Just taking it one day at a time. If you have a job, just keep your job. If you're in a relationship, just keep that relationship if you can. Don't make any great big changes because in early sobriety, there's a lot going on. There's a lot going on and we make these big decisions under stress. Like for myself, going to court, you know, I had a lot of things going on in my life that weren't normal, would probably clear up in a year down the road, but I was making these decisions based on my life at that time. And things will change in sobriety, but we need to give it time. So making big decisions is not a great idea. Just keep the status quo. I know we want to get better jobs. I know we want to be in relationships. I know we want a financial situation to improve, but if we don't pay attention to our sobriety, that house of cards will fall apart. Believe me, because I did it. I was making these great big decisions under an abnormal time in early recovery. When we wake up from the drunken stupor that we're in, we want to change a lot of things. We want things in our lives to change, and I get it. But we need to easy does it and keep it very, very simple and focus on our sobriety. For myself, I had a lot of emotional difficulties. I had a lot of anger issues going on. I felt deep down in my heart that I couldn't even run my own life. You know, but I wanted to be in a relationship and I couldn't even run my own life. I was very immature. I had debt collectors after me. There's a lot of things going on and there's a lot of things I needed to clear up before I move forward in rebuilding in my life. Because that's basically what I'm talking about, rebuilding our lives. To just keep our lives really simple at the beginning. So there's a reason why a lot of old timers tell you don't make big decisions in your first year of recovery, because those decisions can be stress related, can be emotionally charged, or mentally you're overwhelmed and you make the wrong decisions for all the right reasons. Okay, so I hope this video helped. It's been a while since I did a video. I've been on holidays here for the last week, and the boundary issue that I talked about here, the property line issue, hasn't resolved itself yet, so we're still sort of not talking to each other, neighbors and stuff, and caused me a little stress, but I'm not adding to the problem. I'm taking it one day at a time. Okay, so take your life one day at a time, enjoy your sobriety, and try and keep your life very simple and easy does it. That's the key words to this video. Keep it simple and easy does it. Your life will be big in sobriety. You'll have a big, busy life. Your life will come together, believe it. I have a great big life now. I've been in sobriety for many years. But after a few years of my sobriety, I had lots of friends. I had a good job. I was making money. I had a great place to live. All those things that I wanted today, and when I first came into sobriety, did come, but they came slowly and they took more time. And believe it or not, I still have the same job. I end up buying a house. All this kind of stuff happened to me, but I needed to get my sobriety under control. I needed to learn to live comfortably in my own skin and cooperate with the world around me before I can make any big decisions to change. Remember, alcoholism is an addiction, but it's also a mental health issue, and we need to get straightened out. We really do. We need to reach out and get straightened out. Changing your apartment or your girlfriend or your job, they're external things. They will not straighten us out inside and help us move forward with our lives. I know maybe that sounds counterintuitive, but it's really the truth, okay? I would never mislead you, okay? My name is Terry G. This is My Alcohol Free Life Channel, where we learn to live sober one day at a time. If you can take a second, can you please subscribe to my channel, or can you take another second and smash that like button? I really appreciate it, okay? Stay strong, stay safe, stay sober. Together, we can do it one day at a time. I've been doing it with all my buddies, my support network for many, many years. I really have, and without them, I would not be anything. I really wouldn't. Sobriety would be much, much difficult, okay? I'll see you next time. God bless. Ciao for now.